Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to explain a kind of confusing thing for students, and that is writing the null and alternative hypothesis. So the null hypothesis, H sub zero, is always stated using an equal to, less than equal to, or greater than equal to symbol. And the alternative hypothesis, which some books will call H sub one, some will call H sub lowercase a, and some will be H sub uppercase A. I'm going to use usually lower with the one, but they all mean the same thing. And the alternative hypothesis either has not equal to, less than, or greater than. So no equal to parts in the alternative hypothesis. In this class, we'll be following the convention of the textbook, which is to replace the less than equal to or greater than equal to with an equal sign. It may be easier to write the claim originally using the less than equal to or greater than equal to, and then replace it with the equal to sign as you go forward. The null and the alternative hypothesis are always in opposition to one another, so they cannot both be true at the same time. There's really only three combinations of null and alternative hypotheses. If your null hypothesis is equal to, then the alternative is not equal to. If the null is less than or equal to, then the alternative is greater than. And if the null hypothesis is greater than or equal to, then the alternative is less than. All of our H sub zero or null hypotheses will be using equal sign. But at first I'm going to show you what it would look like with the less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, because I think it helps you understand it better. When possible, we're going to use the claim as our alternative hypothesis. And if the claim contains an equal to statement, then we'll have to use it as our null hypothesis. So I have examples here of, I think, just about anything that could come up in your homework. The first one says, the owner claims the average age in the club is equal to 25. Do you see how that says equal in it? Well, this is their claim then. The mean, mu is their mean, and they're saying that's 25. Since they said equal to, then we have to use the equal to as our null, and then the not equal to as our alternative. If the average age was anything but 25, we would be contradicting the null. So if it was less than 25 or if it was greater than 25, and that's why we just say it doesn't equal 25, and that would make it opposite of whatever the null is. And when you have a not equal to for your alternative, when you do testing, you're thinking about a two-tailed test, which we'll get to later on. Okay, second example, the police claim that more than half of all drivers have driven while intoxicated. Okay, so they didn't give us a number here, but when we're saying more than half, we know half is 0.5, and this is a proportion, so I'm using P rather than mu. So we know that the claim is greater than 0.5. So that, in that case, because it doesn't have an equal to part in it, that is our alternative hypothesis. When our alternative hypothesis is greater than, then the null hypothesis is less than or equal to. But for us, in this class, we're going to change that just to equal to, because all of those are going to have just the equal to part. So the claim is the alternative hypothesis. We're going just in one direction here, so we'd have a one-tailed test. Okay, the governor claimed that the mean amount of assistance was less than 356 a month. Again, this is mu. It's less than 356. This statement does not contain an equal sign. So the claim is the alternative hypothesis in this case. It's less than. Since the alternative is less than, the null hypothesis is greater than equal to, which we will then change just to equal to. And because we're going in one direction here, we'd be using a one-tailed test. All right, we claim the proportion of intoxicated drivers on the road is no more than 37%. So we're saying no more than. Well, when you say no more than, it means it could be 37 or it could be less. So that actually implies an equality there. When we see a statement, a claim that has an equal to part in it, that becomes our null hypothesis. So P is less than or equal to 0.37, that's what our null hypothesis is. And since that's less than or equal to, our alternative would be greater than. So we're changing that into equal, for our textbook. So p equals 0.37, and then null hypothesis, it's greater than 0.37. So you can see why I'm saying write it this way first, because then you can see in those opposing signs, right? But when you write it as equal to, it's a little harder to see that. And the last one, the teacher claimed the standard deviation of a test is at least 2.5. If it's at least something, it could be 2.5 or it could be more. And it's talking about standard deviation, so we're using that lower case sigma. So you always have to see what the claim is talking about. So because this again has an equal to part in it, that has to become our null hypothesis. So the null hypothesis is greater than or equal to, which means the alternative is in opposition to that, which is less than. The claim contains equality. That's really the thing you want to think about. If it has an equal to part in it, that's your null hypothesis. The alternative hypothesis is always in opposition to the null. And whenever you have something that's just a less than or greater than, you're using a one-tailed test. All right, I hope this helps. Have a fantastic day. And don't forget to subscribe if you want to see as I post new videos.